السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فهو مهتد ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم يا أيها الذين آمنوا واتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا واتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما اما بعد فان الاصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي مصطفى صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وشر الامور محدثاتها وكل محدثه بدعه وكل بدعه ضلاله وكل ضلاله واهلها في النار ثم اما بعد ايها المسلمون يا اخواني في الله My brothers and sisters in Islam, I stand before you today, and we've come to another Jumu'ah, another Eid Isbu'i, another Eid or another day where we come together to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we do this every Jumu'ah, every Friday. We come together strictly for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Based upon Kitab Allah wa Sunnah to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And this is a great ni'mah for us to have made and lived to come to this day. And yesterday in the masjid, we had a janazah. We had a funeral prayer where one of our brothers or one of our sisters didn't make it to this Jumu'ah. So they started their life in Al-Barzakh. But we still have a chance. We still have a chance to make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do those things which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered us to do in accordance with the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And the purpose or the thing I want to talk about today is something that we are in need of everywhere as Muslims. We're in need of the Islamic Brotherhood, Ya Akhwani Fillah. Because the kuffar, the non-Muslims, they have brotherhood between them. And they're building communities and institutions. So it's upon us, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has favored us and allowed for us to come together for His sake. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't distinguish between us, between our colors and our tribes and our races. Allah doesn't care about if this person is Oromo, for example, or this person is Tigre, or this person is Rehammer, or this person is from this Kabila, or this person is African American. La, la, abadan. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at our hearts. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, قال sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ أَجْسَادِكُمْ وَلَا إِلَىٰ صُورِكُمْ وَلَكِنْ يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ قُلُوبِكُمْ وَأَعْمَالَكُمْ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that verily Allah does not look at your bodies. Allah does not look at your bodies. But Allah, and nor does He look to your, how beautiful you are. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, to your hearts and your deeds. To your hearts and your deeds. This will distinguish us in this life as well as the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered us to be brothers and ordered us to ta'awun ala birri wa taqwa, to work together in piety and fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what does that mean? That means we stay away from those things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited. We stay away from the muharramat. And then we enjoy the khayr. And we do the amr bi ma'roof wa nahi al munkar. Kama qala Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam an Abi Sayyid al-Khudri radiyallahu anhu qala samitu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul من راى منكم منكرا فيغيره بيد فان لم يستطع فبلسان فان لم يستطع فبقلب وذلك اضعف الايمان. رواه مسلم. In this hadith that was collected in Muslim, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said that whoever amongst you sees a munkar, sees sinfulness, من راى منكم منكرا, whoever sees the sinfulness, then change it with his hand. This is if he's able to do so. This is if he's able to do so. And if he's not, then he should change it with his tongue. He should speak against this munkar. Speak against the evil that you see. And then if he's still unable to do so, then he should change it or hate it in his heart. And that is the weakest part of Iman, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said. And also with this hadith, this shows us that Iman, as Ahlul Sunnah believe, Iman is what? Iman, it's on your, it's your deeds. And it is, it's what you do with your hands, and it's what you say in your tongue, and it's in the heart. This is the belief of Ahlul Sunnah. And I mention this, because it has come to me that there is some activities going on in the community. And we ask those people involved in that, those activities, in these festivities, that are not, they're not based on Kitabillah, وَلَا سُنَّةُ الرَّسُولِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. Instead they go against everything that Islam teaches us. And they involve mixing between the men and the women. And they involve alcohol and drinking and munkarat from every place you can find munkarat. And of course this is going to lead to zina. So I ask my brothers and sisters who are involved in this or who want to involve themselves into this activity to stay away from it. But coming back to our mawdu', which is that we have to have the Islamic Brotherhood. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, والمؤمنون والمؤمنات بعضهم أولياء البعض, that the believing men and the believing women, they are supporters of one another. So even with this munkar, how can we support our brothers in this munkar? By advising them. And by stopping them if we can. And as Muslims, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, في كتابه الكريم, إنما المؤمنون إخوة. إنما المؤمنون إخوة. That the believers are brothers. That we have to begin to have the support for one another. And we have to begin to love one another strictly for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not because this one has a lot of wealth, or not because this one is very beautiful, or not because this one is from my tribe, or this one is the same color as me, la abadin. That will never benefit us, ya ikhwan. But instead it's coming back to the state of the person's belief. Are they a believer in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Do you see that this person on the zahir and their outward appearance, at least they have some aspects of iman? You love, Ahlul Sunnah loves the people in accordance with their iman. This is al-wala wal-bara. This is how we love for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and hate those things which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hates. And this is wajib upon the believers and wajib upon us as Muslims. As Muslims who are brothers in Islam, brothers and sisters, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala together. The lack of brotherhood, it leads to many things. It leads to many types of weakness in the community. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, that when we split into groups and sects, if it's based upon our tribe, or based upon our understanding of Islam, that will go astray. قال تعالى في كتابه الكريم وَلَا تَكُونُ كَالَّذِينَ تَفَرَّقُوا وَاخْتَلَفُوا. And do not be like those people who they differ and they use their differences and they go astray from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They go away from the سبيل المؤمنين. وقال تعالى إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينُهُمْ وَكَانَ شِيئًا لَسْتُ مِنْهُمْ شَيْءٍ. That those people who have broken into groups and sects and established their wala based upon their group and their sect, or established their love based upon their kabila, that they have nothing from the deen of Islam in this. These are the umur of jahiliyyah. These are the things that tear apart the ummah. And we're already torn apart everywhere. We're weak. We can't come together because of this ta'asub, because of racism, and because of tafarraq, because we've divided. But at the same time, ya ikhwani fillah, we have a lot of khair in the ummah. And this masjid alone bears the witness. As I look to my right and my left, I see brothers from everywhere, walillah alhamd. And I see that this masjid was built by the wealth of many different people from different nations. And this is a ni'mah. This shows we can ta'awun. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تزال طائفة من أمتي ظاهرين على الحق حتى يأتيهم أمر الله وهم على ذلك. Or كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has said that there won't cease to be a group from my community, from my nation, that is openly on the haq, that's openly on the truth, until they meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, until the day of judgment. So this shows us that we have hope. And this shows us that Ahlul Sunnah Mawjood Al-An, that our Muslim Brotherhood is here. We're working together. But we have a long way to go. And especially in a place like this, where we live and we're surrounded by non-Muslims, it's difficult for us to practice at times. So we have to even have more brotherhood. We have to even have more ta'awun, based upon Kitab wa Sunnah. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد. الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد. So as I mentioned, brothers and sisters, the importance of trying to work together and the importance of us trying to actualize that Islamic brotherhood that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us to do. And that as Muslims, we should not despise each other. As Muslims, we should sincerely love each other. Whenever we see a brother or sister come into the fold of Islam, we should have happiness in our hearts. And we should want to share with that person the message of Islam and teach them Islam. Teach them the Quran. And teach them the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And we cannot despise each other, as I said. And in a hadith on Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu, قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم المسلم أخو المسلم لا يخونه ولا يكذبه ولا يخذله كل مسلم على مسلم حرام دمه إرده وماله ودمه بحسب the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that the Muslim is the brother of the Muslim, that he doesn't cheat his Muslim brother and sister, and he doesn't lie to him, and that he doesn't cheat him. Every Muslim has rights upon his Muslim brothers and sisters. Their wealth is sacred, and their blood is sacred, and their honor is sacred. And this is in accordance with the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث الآخر المؤمن للمؤمن كالبنيان يشده بعضه بعضا. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the believer is the brother of the believer. They're like a building. They strengthen and support one another. This is the example for us. This is how we can get out of this mashakle that we have, this problem that we have, by having this ta'awun and strengthening one another. And a real story I recently saw, it was in one of the masajid here in the Seattle area, and a brother, I hadn't seen him in a long time, in many years. And the brother said, yes, I drive a taxi. And that I'm homeless now. Subhanallah. And I was thinking, unfortunately, I didn't get a chance to really spend time with him. He disappeared from the masjid very quickly. But this should never be the case. We should have a means or a way that our brothers and sisters that are in struggle, that they have a place to stay, at least temporarily. Especially in this difficult economic time. That if our Muslim brother or sister is hungry, that we feed them. If they need shelter, we give them shelter. Even if it's temporary. This is what we have to do as Muslims, as brothers and sisters in Islam. That we have to begin to think about these things. Because it can happen to any of us. Any of us could be without the support. So we have to support one another. And again, as I said, the Muslim doesn't despise his Muslim brother and sister. That you should love them in accordance with their obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we should help one another, all of us. And do not be suspicious of one another. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, إِيَّاكُمْ وَالظُّنُّ إِيَّاكُمْ وَالظُّنُّ فَإِنَّ الظُّنُّ أَكْذِبُ الْحَدِيثِ وَلَا تَحَاسُدُوا وَلَا تَجَاسُسُوا وَلَا تَبَاغُدُوا وَلَا تَدَابُرُوا وَلَا تَنَاجِشُوا وَكُنُّوا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ إِخْوَانًا. وكما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in this hadith, which means, إِيَّاكُمْ وَالظُّنُّ, do not be suspicious. Beware of suspicion. Because suspicion, it is the worst of lying speech. And do not have hasid for one another. Do not have envy for one another. Meaning that if you see your Muslim brother or sister having a nice vehicle, or they have many children, or they have nice clothes, that you don't have hasad, you don't have envy for them. Instead, you should wish khair for them. You should want good for them. And that also in this hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وَلَا تَجَاسِسُوا, and do not spy on one another. So don't go make a tafteesh for one another's mistakes. Don't look and see, let's see what so-and-so is doing. But have husnul dhun, have a good outlook on your brothers and sisters. Don't be pessimistic and don't spy on them. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also mentioned the type of tanajishu. He mentioned, which is a type of like bidding, to bid over your brother when your brother wants to buy something, or even this applies when someone wants to get married. If someone is already they have engagement with a Muslim woman, and then another person comes and they want to become engaged with this woman, this is haram until those two have decided they don't want to marry. So as well, the tanajis, it has to do with buying and selling. That if your Muslim brother or sister wants to buy something, that another person doesn't come and falsely try to raise the price. And this happens in bidding. For example, someone comes and he says, two individuals want to buy and sell, and another individual comes just to raise the price. He really doesn't even want to buy. This is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was mentioning. And in this same hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, وَلَا تَدَابَرُوا, and don't turn your backs on your brother Muslims and sisters. So don't ignore one another, and don't cut one another off, unless it's based on Kitab wa Sunnah. Unless it's based on the du'a of the Kitab wa Sunnah, meaning the criterion that's established by the Qur'an and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the last thing the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, وَلَا تَبَاغَدُوا, and don't hate one another. Do not hate your Muslim brothers and sisters, but love them. Even the person who has weak iman, if you see that they're open in sins, we dislike their sins, na'am. But we want good for them. We want them to leave the shur and come back to the khair. Because all of us have mistakes. We're all sinners. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, كُلُّ إِنُّ آدَمْ خَطَّى وَخَيْرِ الْخَطَائِينَ تَوَابُونَ, that all the children of Adam are sinners. And the best of those people who sin are those who come back and make tawbah. They make repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And no one can prevent you from your repentance. That's between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't have to do as the Jews and the Christians, or the Christians or the Catholics do. We don't have to go to the Imam and say, oh Imam, I've sinned. Can you make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Or can you pass this tawbah to Allah? La abadan. This is what the mushriks do. This is what the people of shirk and kufr do. But as a Muslim, you can have your direct relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase our brotherhood and bless us to unite as one ummah. Based on kitabi wa sunnah, based on kitabi la wa sunnah to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless our brothers and sisters in Somalia to make a ballad of tawheed based on kitab wa sunnah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless our brothers and sisters in Iraq as well, in Afghanistan, and Chechnya, and Bosnia, and anywhere the Muslims are suffering, and here in America as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with ilm nafi'a wa rizqan tayyiban wa amalan mutaqabbilan wa ikhlas fi deen wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Aqimu as-salat.